Doc Woods on the red carpet for the 2022 Twin Cities Film Fest. I am your host, and we are here with three of the actors from the show, from the movie Jasmine is a Star. So first, what we're going to do is have them introduce themselves and the characters that they played, starting with you.
Hi, I'm Sarah Marsh, and I play Ms. Figueroa.
Hi, my name is Sasha Andreev, and I play the director of a photo shoot that Jasmine takes part in.
I'm Sam Bardwell, and I play the photographer at that photo shoot.
Speaking of that photo shoot, gentlemen, I did have an opportunity to see the movie. And I will say, as the director of that shoot, your character wasn't the most likable. Mm-hmm. I'd like to say, what is your process to getting into a character where you know you may be perceived as the antagonist or a bad guy, especially in a film like this?
Sure. Well, the biggest trick to it is that you have to find the good in what you're doing. And because the character doesn't perceive himself as being bad, he's just making decisions that he feels are right at that time. So you kind of have to move through that film with blinders. So even though you know the context of what's happening within that moment, I'm the good guy. And anyone who has a problem with it is the bad guy to me, essentially.
Okay. And for the other two, how do you get into character?
I just try to stay present in the scene and live through the dialogue and really bounce off my fellow actors. So for me, it's really in the words. And I'm a very physical actor, so my environment and how I feel physically in the moments, costumes, that kind of thing. So staying present really is key for me.
Yeah, I would say yes to everything my colleagues have said, and I think that work of understanding the water you're swimming in and what, you know, my particular character is, how he functions in this story, that in that particular, while I agree with Sasha that my photographer has all sorts of things going on in his mind, I also know as an actor that he's very much not the center of that scene, and that I choose projects based on the makers and what I think they're saying and how I can service that and leverage my privilege in telling an important story being told by the right people. And yeah, there's a, you know, I don't know that I'd want to meet my character and that I'd get all that, you know, that we'd be buddies, but I really understand that Joe wrote a really specific thing that that character needs to do, and it's a really painful part of the process of dehumanizing someone, you know, and that's what I can offer in this moment, and agreed everything about doing the actor work of being present and being a body in space and alive, but your kind of function is a sad one.
My interview with Jill, she said this is a story about perseverance. Which one of you would like to give us a story or something personal that you have had to persevere through in your life?
Sure, I can do that. So I run a theater company, a small theater company, and the last couple of years have been incredibly difficult with the pandemic and just what's happened in our industry. And so, honestly, the last couple of years, just, you know, keeping faith and not giving up and asking for help, and I'm fortunate to be part of an incredible community and amazing supporters and artists. And going through that, that's really the latest anecdote of perseverance. There have been many, but that's the one that's most fresh for me.
That's probably keeping that perseverance going. That applies to most people in this industry, where we've had to reconfigure what our goals are, what's important to us. I think people have left the industry or have shifted in the way they function, and maybe even respect themselves a bit more now, because we feel that we know what it's like to be without it, and we know what's important to us. So if we choose to go back into it, I see a lot of people standing up for themselves in a way they hadn't before.
Hey, any lasting comments for you?
Grateful to be things have been a lot easier for me than they are for a lot of people. So again, it's kind of a matter of my role as often as a supporter of voices that I think are important and offering my body in those places. I've struggled in being feeling underemployed, but at a time like this, you really rejoice to be attached to such an important piece of work made by the right folks. So,
as you just said, an important piece of work. It's not just a story, but it's a life and that people live and go through. So we appreciate you all sharing your time and your talents to this film. And again, I am Doc Woods, your red carpet host for the 2022 Twin Cities Film Fest. and we are here with three of the stars of Jasmine is a Star, and we'll get your names and roles one more time.
Hi, I'm Sarah Marsh, and I play Ms. Figueroa.
Hi, I'm Sasha Andreev. I play the director of the photo shoot.
Sam Bardwell, I play the photographer at that photo shoot.
I am Doc Woods, signing off.
Thank you. Well done. Yeah, great. It's a brilliant thing to do.
Yeah. My character actually has a name, but I